Welcome back. We have been discussing on the life cycle of Fasciola, that is the liver function. The last aspect is the parasitic adaptations exhibited by liver function, parasitic adaptations of liver function. The parasitic adaptations of liver function can be considered under two categories. One is degenerations and the other is neoformations. Degenerations, includes or it involves the loss or reductions of existing structures, that is degenerations. Okay. It is actually whatever structures are present in a normal individual, if it is lost or if it is reduced, those are considered under degenerations. Okay. While neoformations is, as the name suggests, newly formed. Okay, the formation of new structures or modification of existing ones to suit the life cycle or the life of Fasciola. That is what is considered under neoformation. Now, degenerations include two aspects. One is absence of locomotor, respiratory and circulatory organs in the case of Fasciola. The liver and the bile duct of sheep, it provides Fasciola is a very safe and secure space to live. It provides food and all the requirements are fulfilled. So what happens is it doesn't require to move about. So it doesn't require any locomotory structure. So it is completely absent. Similarly, free molecular oxygen is not available in the liver. It is an anaerobic condition over there. So it doesn't need any respiratory structure as well. Okay. Then what about the circulatory system? The nutrients, it is being distributed by through the branching intestine, the alimentary canal, directly to various places. It doesn't have any circulatory system. Instead, the gas, even the alimentary canal, the digestive system itself acts as a gastrovascular system. What is vascular? Vascular means vessels. Usually, we use the vascular in the case of animals with respect to the circulatory system. Okay, vascular means vessels, right? So usually we refer we use the term vascular with respect to the circulatory system. But here what happens is it is the alimentary canal, the highly branched alimentary canal itself acting as a circulatory system. Okay. So what happens? It doesn't need any separate specific circulatory structures, right? So circulatory system is altogether absent, right? Now the second one we can see is absence of sense organs. Fasciola, as already mentioned, is always inside, inside the bile duct, isn't it? It doesn't have to move from one place to another. And it doesn't get to experience different changing environmental conditions, right? So they don't need to have any sensory structures to perceive these external stimuli, right? So they have their nervous system very poorly developed and sense organs, specialized sense organs are altogether absent. Fine. Now, regarding the neoformations. Neoformations, as a part of their parasitic adaptation or parasitic mode of life, they have developed a very resistant, protective tegument. Right. They have a resistant, a protective outer covering, and this outer covering is known as a tegument. And this provides protection against the chemical action of bile and other chemicals in the host body. So it is a neoformation. Now there is a presence of adhesive organs. As already mentioned, in the case of platyhelminthes, most of the parasitic platyhelminthes do have the adhesive organs. It could be hooks, botulia, etc., suckers, spines, etc. In the case of Fasciola, they cannot live outside the liver or outside the bile duct of sheep. So it has to remain permanently attached to certain parts of inside the bile duct without getting removed along with the bile. And so it has to get adhered to the internal lining, and that is brought about with the help of the highly developed suckers and spines on them. Okay, so they do have such kind of adhesive organs. Now, as already mentioned, reside in the bile duct where there is no free oxygen. So, it is not an aerobic condition in the bile duct. It is anaerobic. And Fasciola do have to develop a high power of anaerobic respiration. And to overcome these issues of anaerobic condition, They usually rely upon the energy which is obtained through glycolysis. As you are already familiar with the glycolytic process, isn't it? Glycolysis is a process which can happen both in aerobic as well as anaerobic condition. Right. So, the fasciola, it depends solely for their energy purpose on anaerobic glycolysis. So, they have developed a high power of anaerobic respiration. The next one we have is the hermaphroditism. Again, the development of the particular character. It is because they don't have locomotory structures and they can't move about to find the opposite sex during the reproduction. So, what happens? They have developed hermaphroditism. While discussing on the reproduction development life cycle, we already mentioned that even though fasciola is a hermaphrodite, it is cross-fertilization is very common. Now, self-fertilization is very rare. Only it happens only when cross-fertilization is not at all possible, right? But still, hermaphroditism is a parasitic adaptation. Right? The next one is high fecundity and polyembryonic. Now, what is a fecundity? Fecundity means reproductive capacity. That is, in a single split, how many new individuals are produced. In a single birth, how many new individuals are produced? That is fecundity. So, it is having a high fecundity, that is high reproductive capacity. So, what happens is, in a single reproductive phase, it can produce thousands of individuals, and hence it can keep up with the generation. Okay, now what is polyembryonic? Polyembryonic is actually development of several individuals from a single embryo. Okay, development of several larvae from a single embryo is what is known as a polyembryonic. Okay, so again, what happens? It needn't spend too much of energy for the production of what we call embryo. Even then, they get so many of the larval stages. So that is again a parasitic adaptation, right? So it is a very important aspect with regard to the survival of fasciola as a parasite. So this is all about fasciola. We saw fasciola, the morphological features, the different forms it exists in, the morphology, the life cycle, what are the different phases in the life cycle, etc. Okay. In the coming videos, we'll be looking into the next group, that is the class Cystoda and the examples in that. Okay. So for the while,